today we're going to talk about stringers. And stringers come in many forms. We sell commercial stringers that are already pulled, so they're about that thickness, different colours. That clear one is in even thinner. You can pull your own, so I'll show you how to pull your own as well. First you light your torch, mine's already lit. And what you do is you heat up a small amount of glass at the end of your rod. Now you can pull stringers using tweezers. There's various types. I use angled tweezers. And another way of pulling stringers is by using just a little rod. So I've just got a little clear rod here. So I'll show you that method first. So I've heated my little ball at the end. Bring it out of the flame. Just let it cool a little. Put your stringer on. Attach it. That's a cold stringer. And then you pull. As you can see, it's quite thin. Slightly thicker at that end. You then use the flame to break it off. So if you've got it on a stringer, you can then use it like a pen. You find. There's plenty of stringer here, so you cut it down to the lengths you require. You can also leave it on the end of your rod and use it as a pen again, like how we did with this stringer. So they were quite thin. If you wanted to pull a thicker stringer, and I'll show you how I do it with tweezers, just the same method. I often do a bigger ball and there's more glass to pull. And then I pull it slower. So that's a bit bigger ball. I leave it to cool slightly out of the flame, grab the end of my tweezers and I start to pull slowly. So as you can see, it's getting darker as it cools and that's a lot thicker. So you make sure it's set before you let go. Use the flame again. Remember, they are hot, but the thin ones do cool down quickly actually. So we'll leave that as a rod on the end. So that's how to pull generally a stringer. To pull really thin stringers, if you're doing stringer work where you can draw with them, I like to do. You need to pull them really, really fine. So you only need a small amount. Grab the end and pull as fast as you can. And it'll go like hair like. So I'll break them off. Unfortunately, you won't be able to see, but my stringer is attached to my hand and the rod, and it is bending. When you bend it, it's got flexibility, that's when you can draw with them. So I'm breaking those off. You place them on the desk somewhere where you can see them. As they are very thin, and you can hardly find them sometimes. We're going to make a bead and show how to use stringers. So we're going to use just plain white 205, 204, sorry. This will show up better for the video. Right, I've made a bead and I'm going to flatten it to give it a better surface so you can see on the video. So that'll be big enough for now, just to show the example. Just getting the bead out of it. I've made a barrel type bead. Which gives me more surface to play on. And I'm just going to flatten it. I use mashers. I'm going to just use some graphite. Gives us a flat surface to play on. Turn my torch down slightly. So these are commercial stringers. These are already pulled for you. They're usually quite good and some are a bit thicker than the other ones. So I always hold a stringer like a pen. Give you more control. So heat the area you want to put your stringer on. Heat a bit of glass. Stringers are good for doing dots because it gives you more control. There's less glass to melt. It also helps you get them pretty much the same size. So there's just simple dots you can do with stringers. We can do lines, again, heat up the area. And use the flame underneath to heat the stringer and carefully move it round. So you get a swirly pattern, which is quite thick when you think of the stringer. You can pull your own stringers, like I showed in the other video. So on the back we'll do that. Sometimes stringers get a little ball on the end here, so I always cut them off. Just break them with your fingers carefully. So again, you heat the bead where you want it to go. Lay the stringer on. And carefully use the heat underneath the flame to guide it. And you need some heat control. And if they're quite thick, you can't often get it quite as smooth as you want it to. Try again. So heat the area you want, start it off, and use the heat to gently move your bead rather than the stringer. Sometimes helps. So that's a stringer I've pulled, slightly thicker than I would normally pull, but it's thinner than the bought one. This is a stringer pulled on a rod, which is very thin. So we'll try that method. This is a good way of controlling a thin stringer. And it's literally just like writing with a pen. So it gives great control. As you can see, so a different effect from a thinner stringer. And these are stringers I've pulled as well. Again, they need the end taken off. Sometimes it helps to keep the flame quite soft. Remember to always heat your bead though, because while you're concentrating on stringer work, your bead is getting cold. It's easy to get lose concentration on it. So here we are heating the bead, and then the heat just glides along the stringer to the end. If you want to do it a flat, a line, I mean, lay the stringer on the heated bead, just lay it across and it should go straight across. Also make sure your stringer is stuck at one end. If it doesn't stick to one end, it'll roll back on itself, which is what happened on this side. So my stringer stuck there, and then it wasn't enough heat to stick it to the bead, so it became a gap and then a dot and a gap and a dot. On this side, the stringer has gone in a straight line all the way to the bottom. Always heat your bead after doing stringer work in case your work is not stuck to the main bead. You can melt the stringer work in, or you can leave it raised. So that just gives examples of what you could possibly use stringers for. I'm going to make a bead with some very fine black, deep black stringers, some enamels, and I'm going to make like a flowery bead. And the enamels is going to sit on the base of the bead first, and I'm going to draw over the top. I'm using a straight-sided lentil, large, which is that size, for my shape. So first start by getting prepared for everything you need. So I've got my enamel in a little pot. I've got a little sieve so I can scoop it up. I've pulled a lot of stringers, and my stringers are of various thicknesses. I don't know if you can see them, but they're all bendy because they're very thin. So some are really hair-like, some are slightly thicker. You want different sizes, different lengths, and you need quite a lot because you tend to run out, they break quite easily. So I'm going to use white as a base because I think it's Right, because I'm using a lentil press, I need to know whether how far I need to go. So I've got a little bit further to go before I start building up my bead. Again, test it again. I sometimes use my graphite to swirl it around a bit. I need a little bit more before I start building it up. I keep pressing it in so I can judge how much glass I've got. Still need more. Building it up in the middle now. It's not far off. That's pretty much okay. So I'm just going to tweak my ends a bit. This one lens is round. One end is square. I'm just going to heat the end. Move it with a razor tool. So I'm going to put that in there. Press on. Flatten it. That's my base bead already made. Right, now I'm going to put some enamels on. So very carefully, I have to try and get a mask on without burning myself. Need some water. So I'm going to scoop the enamel up. This one is new purple. I'm going to heat the bead where I want the enamel to go. And then over a bowl of water, I sprinkle it on. Then I heat it up again. And depending on how much thickness of enamel you want, you can add more. Again, just use the press to keep the shape. That's okay. I'll do three enamels. Right, so we're going to do a freeform flower. So get your stringers, the thinner the better, if you can cope with them. Just turn the torch down a bit. This is where you need a bit of control now. So you heat the area where you want to put your stringer. I grip it within two fingers like that. And my stringer is at this side. And I don't have a lot at the beginning. So use the heat. Use the heat and bend the stringer. Watch your fingers. Get a little ball at the end, take it off. And you work fairly fast. Now they do ping off, they do break continuously sometimes. And just join it on and persevere. Heat the stringer you've just put on your bead back on. Good to be free form, because if something slightly goes wrong, it's not as precise. But it's all practice at the end of the day, and you'll get better and better every time you do one. Some days are better than others. I don't know if you can see, but I've started to add some petals. We've got a little gap there, which doesn't really matter. I might leave that one actually. So it's a bit awkward now because I've got to turn it the other way. My string is getting a bit short. I'll put another one. You soon realise why you need a lot of them. The thinner the better, so the more bend in them, the better they work, to be honest. Okay, so I've gone round and I've heated all my bead up. I've got this petals drawn. I'm now going to just put some little lines in between the petals. I tend to stand up when I do string work because I feel more in control. I think it's because I can look overhead. and see what's happening. When you want to break it off, just lift it out of flame and it'll break as it goes cold. You can also blow it. And that also breaks it. Right, I think that'll do. Again, heat it up. Don't forget the back. A bit of heat there. Make sure it's all sealed, fastened in on the top of the glass bead. Again, tray it in there. Just still the same size. So that's, looks like a lot of lines, but that's the petals. So I'm going to get a bit of a thicker stringer now. I'm going to put some dots in the middle. They're like stamens, but where I've done a little line in the middle of the petal is where like stamens would be. I think that's the right word. So I'm just going to put a dot at the end of each of the little lines. And watch your fingers. It's very small there. Again, heat them in, heat the back. You can leave them raised if you wanted to, add a little bit more interest. So that's the lines and little dots at the end. Might leave them raised actually. And I'm just going to do a few in the middle, which also neatens up anything you've got to hide in the middle. So don't forget, the thinner the stringer, the better. But if you can see, the bottom one is the better one because it's thinnest and it moves more. Heat it all the way around, and that's the bead. So it's just a case of practicing, drawing, anything you want. Try writing, that's quite fun. Write your name on the back. And then put it in the cooling bubbles or a kiln.